Good morning, John. A couple of warnings about this video. First, if you find cuteness offensive, you should probably leave now. Also, if you are prone to squee, take the necessary precautions. Today's video is about the tiniest things. I'm doing this, of course, because the world's smallest chameleon was recently discovered in Madagascar, and it is very tiny. And I'm also doing it because the episode of SciShow that we did on tardigrades went really, really well. Honey Badger don't care? Really? Maybe shove Honey Badger out of an airlock into the vacuum of space and see if he cares then. Tardigrade don't care. Dun 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 tardigrades! This little guy, while being very, very tiny, is not the smallest reptile. That honor goes to the Virgin Island Dwarf Gecko! Pictured here, full grown on a dime. The Virgin Island Dwarf Gecko does not, however, take the prize for smallest vertebrate. That either goes to a frog or a fish, depending on which side of the controversy you're on. It makes sense that the smallest vertebrate would be water dwelling because they do not have to deal with the pressure of gravity as much because they get to be underwater. Now, I will tell you the name of this frog, but I can't pronounce it. Here it is pictured on a dime. Apparently that's the thing to do, unless you're the world's smallest snake, in which case you're so massive that you have to be pictured on a quarter. For people who aren't American, this is a dime. It's our smallest coin, even though it's worth more than pennies and nickels, and this is a quarter. So that's how big those animals are. But even smaller than that frog is a fish. A fish that we nerdfighters know a little bit about, but I did not know that it was the smallest vertebrate, the male anglerfish! Though most biologists don't count it because it relies on sexual parasitism to survive.
But whatever!
I'm on the anglerfish side of that debate. I'm on the anglerfish side of every debate! Okay, I'm willing to admit that so far this hasn't been particularly cute, but we're gonna change that around by now going to smallest warm-blooded animals. And the smallest warm-blooded creature is the bee hummingbird in- Oh! He's a cute little cutie. The smallest mammal, however, harder to determine. By length, the smallest mammal is Kitty's hog-nosed bat, which I think is adorable. And by mass, the Etruscan shrew is the smallest mammal. So I'm gonna go with the Etruscan shrew, because mass seems like the one you wanna go with there. And oh my god, is it cute! There was, however, once upon a time, a smaller mammal. The long-extinct Batadoinidis van Houtenai, a kind of shrew, which I only mention because of the Van Houten. And finally, our last wild animal. The world's smallest primate. Madam Bertha's mouse lemur.
It weighs just over an ounce, and it's so squishy, little squeeze on the board, and
Shut up! And then we have a selection of domestic animals. Ducky at 1.4 pounds, the current smallest dog. Thumbelina, a miniature horse that turned out to be way more miniature than any other miniature horse at just 17 inches tall, which does not sound healthy. And we're finishing off on Mr. Peebles. Hello, Mr. Peebles. Mr. Peebles is my favorite animal of this video because it led me to the Google search of cat in a cup, where I found so many cats in cups!
It's a cat in a cup! It's a cat in a cup, girl! It's a cat in a cup! Oh yeah! It's a cat in a cup!
John, I'll see you on Tuesday. Oh, did you say that you wanted a Nerdfighter shirt? Ah, well, I can do that for you. I made a no edge design. It's like my face. I'm doing like... It's available now for pre-order at dftba.com.